Well, so long as you have a plan.
Drake's Fang should be just beyond these springs. Shall we press on?
One rock looks a lot like... Hopefully, this is what Seven needs.
Come on, girl. The gate's open now. We can press on.
What the hell are those things?
Something awful's taken up residence in the springs. You'll turn back if you know what's good for you.
By the flames. That explains the heat. Let's cool things down a bit. Let's hope it's enough to keep the baths from boiling.
I saw with my own two eyes what you did to those devils down there, and I still hardly believe it.
Broken down, you say?
from the weight of its load.
Aye. The guards are furious about it. You'd do well to steer clear.
Well, if it's blocking the road, it'd be a wasted journey anyway.
Trader, are you? Seeking your fortune down in the golden sands of Dalamil? From mercantile stock myself, as it happens. You'd never guess, but I was born just down the road in Dravosht. And like me old ma and pa, I've been wandering the world hunting Gilbard's blessing ever since. Reckon I might have found it, too. You've heard about the famous healing waters they got round these parts, right? Well, I'm thinking, if I can find a little pool of my own, dress it up a bit, lay on drinks and fancies and whatnot, I'd have a license to mint gill. Soothing your aches and pains with a grape in your gob and a glass in your hand. There's nothing people wouldn't pay.
Come on, girl. The gate's open now. We can press on.
We should get going soon.
Finally, we'll be able to get one.
Hanging lanterns! Keep the darkness! There he is! The man who saved my business. I was hoping we'd be seeing you again. The baths grow more bearable by the moment. It won't be long now before we are back to business as usual.
I'm glad to hear it.
Now, tell me this. What did you find at the terraces? What threatened to make me a pauper?
Not what I expected, that's for certain.
You tell a fine story. That's not to say I don't believe you, though. Creatures made of flame, eh? That's something new to worry about. But I burdened you with my worries enough already. Here, a small something by way of thanks. Right. It's high time I got back to work. With a little luck, the day might yet be salvaged.
You and the master are working together now. Glad to have you on board.
I wasn't sure how much you'd need, but I hope this is enough.
You are one of the good ones, you know that.
You and that merchant both, she's got quite a gift for teaching, that one.
Now, time to see if limestone is the secret weapon we were hoping for. That'll do, I reckon. A knife forged from the very rocks of Dalamil. Her spirit, if you will.
It's a fine-looking blade.
I only hope Master Lubor agrees.
That sounds like my cue. And just as well.
I was getting tired of waiting.
I'm sorry, Forgemaster Lubor.
Let's take a look then, shall we? First things first, Sava, do you think this is a carving knife worthy of the fine people of Dalamil?
I'd like to think so. But what do you think?
What do I think indeed? It's sharp-ish, but it won't last long with hard use. And it's heavy, heavier than it should be. You might not think it just to hold it for a moment, but sell that to a cook and you'll never hear the end of it. It looks like someone paid a visit to the terraces. The limestone was a step in the right direction, granted, but one that still leaves you short of the mark.
And I was so certain I had it all worked out.
I don't know who you found to teach you that little trick, but it certainly shows initiative. Next question. How much do you think I would charge if I'd made this?
Well, if it took you even a fraction of the time it took me, I would say you could demand a heavy purse.
And who would be able to pay that? The butcher? The hunter? The cooks over at the inn? Dalamil is home to humble traders, not wealthy lords and ladies. Rule number one in any business, Sava, know your customers.
Yes, Forgemaster.
This is just about passable. But only just. I'd say you're worth keeping around a little longer. Starting tomorrow, you'll have an anvil of your own.
I will. Thank you. I was wondering, what would you do if you were asked to forge a carving knife?
I'd do what I always do. Ask who it's for. If it was for the butcher, I'd make sure it holds an edge. For the hunter, I'd make it as tough as Titan. For the cook, light as a feather. And for the nobleman, I'd make it cost an absolute fortune.
There goes a master, all right.
It looks like congratulations are in order.
I couldn't have done it without you. So much for the Forge Master's riddle, though, eh? The spirit of Dalamil had nothing to do with limestone or anything much at all. Meaning, I had you run around for no good reason.
You've passed your test. That's all that matters. You'll have a forge of your own in no time.
And when I do, I'll craft you the finest carving knife you have ever seen.
Honestly, don't think I could have done it without all your help.
Fresh bread, warm from the oven.
Plates and pots!
Bowls and silver platters! Just like they do.
We should get going soon.
Come on, girl, again.
Get that damned wagon fixed! Unless you'd rather our men in Dalamil starved.
Thanks, girl.
The axle's gone, Captain. There's nothing I can do.
There it is. Drake's Fang.
Kuku will be hiding inside.
Along with goodness knows how many guards, all on highest alert, you'll need to keep your wits about you if you're to reach him. So be careful.
I will, Uncle.
Before you go, Clive, allow me to apologize. After what befell at Phoenix Gate, and the crisis that followed in its wake, I fled. I retreated to my counting house and danced attendance upon the Vicereine in the hope it would bring me favor. I betrayed my nation to save my skin, like the coward I am. And I'm sorry.
Uncle, please.
It's not too late, Clive. Rosaria is yours by right, and there are those that would help you to take it back. Had I the courage of my brother, I might already have done so. But that ship has sailed. You, however.
No. Forgive me, but I cannot. I fight to build a new world now. A better world. Where men can live and die on their own terms. I was raised in a nation that strove to improve the plight of bearers. Only later did I realize that spark of freedom did not arise by chance, but was kindled by my father. You would see me follow in his footsteps. And that is exactly what I mean to do. Not by ruling Rosaria, but by extending his ideals to the whole of the Twins. Though every soul in the realm may judge my actions heresy, I am certain my cause is just.
You really are just like him, you know? Thank you, Clive, for coming back to me. I am proud to call you nephew. Well then, this is where we must part ways. Wish me luck in convincing my Canvarian friend to share his considerable talents. I mean to plunder his coffers and prove myself worthy of a place in your merry band. Till then, my boy.
Till then. Go safely, Uncle.
And you, nephew. We have much to catch up on, you and I. I shall expect you to regale me with the tales of all your adventures when next we meet. You can regale me too, Torgal.
I'm coming for you, Kuka.
a rat done to me. Out of my sight, witch! I'll kill you, Rosfield! I'll rip out your heart! I'll tear you limb from limb!
Peace, Hugo. The table shan't hurt you any longer.
He sought to humiliate me. Me! If you hadn't interfered, he would be dead!
You truly believe you would have triumphed had the battle continued?
Titan would have ground him into dust!
And how would he have done that without his head?
Shut up!
You weren't strong enough, and you call yourself a dominant. Or rather, you did.
You mock me, Harbert.
Do you see, Hugo? You are weak.
Fuck.
But so long as that fire burns within you, there is still hope. There may yet be a way for you to take your revenge.
Tell me, what must I do? Please, I'll do anything. Just tell me.
Mothercrystal's heart is the most concentrated source of aether in all creation. Perhaps you could take advantage of that. Of course, the crystal would not yield her blessing to any ordinary man. But then, you are no ordinary man, are you, Hugo? Clive Rosfield stole your power. But others have suffered a similar fate, and still manage to find the strength to conjure their Eikon. Like Benedicta Harmon. She too drank of the aether and gained a power beyond human understanding. Run along now, Hugo. You need only follow the light. Muthos is here. Very well, it shall be so. You may leave everything to me. Your Majesty.
rocks. Did the royalists bring them from Ash? Beastmen part of the Waluda army now. How the hell did that happen? They've spotted us.
matters. This must be the way out. Come on, Torgo. Kuka never did do things by halves. As if taking the Mother Crystal to his own wasn't enough. He had to build his castle in it.
Let the trial begin.
With me, Torgo.
Seems we're expected.
So this is the power of Muthos.
What the hell is going on? Are these things here for me? Or for him? First orcs, now these nightmares. Is this your doing, Ultima?
Yeah!
You've been busy, Kupka. But where did you go? He's in the sanctuary. I can feel it. Come on, Torgal. Just what I needed.
Yeah.
Benedicta. My everything. I've missed you so much.
Kuka!
I swear to you, my love. We will never be parted again.
What's wrong with him?
Again. trick. But if you can do it, then so could I!